Knowledge is power in a company like Stagna Corps. Yes, even during good times, trust and therefore the level of relationships remains low, especially when their own results need to be sacrificed. There's an ongoing, silent power struggle, so the entitlement grows. Marketing claims that they have everything to say about what sales is doing. They actually claim sales is a part of marketing. Sales support and other supporting departments are claimed by sales. HR and finance, they actually think they can stick their private parts in anyone they meet in the hallway. Still, all love to speak about it like we are a very strong management team. But in reality, everyone is very much in each other's way. Compared to Florex, the management team of Stagna Corps seems to be much more goal-oriented. That's the language you usually hear. They don't work for each other. They don't work certainly for the CEO. They work for no one, actually. Think of it. No relationship, you work for no one. You also seek no one's recognition. We work for the company, they say. We work for the targets. Intrinsic motivation. Marketing even goes as far as saying, we work for the brand. The Stagna Corp leadership hides their lack of relationship by strengthening the connections. They actually spend time together, wining and dining. Every year they take the plane and they go somewhere warm and expensive. Their telephones are full of birthdays. So when one of their children has his birthday, the telephone goes off. Hey, Joey, I heard your child is... Oh, how nice of you to remember. In the meantime, they withhold essential information for each other. What do these people do with their own departments? This is a team. These are the middle managers. The director of this group of sergeants live in a world of distrust, of no relationship. No recognition is granted, nor asked, nor gotten, nor taken. So if you don't need sergeants as a source of recognition for your own people, you start to see them actually as a kind of minions. I don't mean the ones from Walt Disney. So what they do is they start to put the sergeants into the teams. He has no special position. He has no special privileges. People do not work for him because he's a powerless ass anyway. In Dutch, we call it meewerkend voorman. How do you call this in English? Meewerkend voorman. Who has a suggestion?
Co-leader?
Nee.
Primus inter pares.
Primus inter pares. There's always a Latin solution for everything. So, the middle manager is now eliminated from the layer of management. You know what? Things really get cynical when exactly these people that eliminate their sergeants now say, we have a very flat organization. And they actually boast about it. We have a flat organization, very short lines. What does it actually mean? You cut out the most important thing. It's like a man who willfully castrates himself and then starts to boast, hey, I created more room in my pockets. Really. It's important to understand what the situation of a Stagna Corp type of manager is. He has no sergeant, so he has a lot of reports. And without trustees, because a sergeant is also your trustee, he has no way of leading them all. So lacking all these crucial relationships that you have with sergeants, a Stagna Corp's manager actually starts to lose touch with his own department. It looked like they own the stuff, but they don't. Just like the Stagna Corp CEO is completely blind to what's really happening in his own management team. So what will happen? Will the director say, we have to solve the leadership problem? Will they become people that you actually would like to work for? Of course not. They will finally do something by buying a lot of systems. So when there's no leadership, they simply buy self-leading principles. They actually, with these kind of things, celebrate their own lack of leadership. Just like they delude themselves in their own management team, it goes now all the way down, and now everybody has to be intrinsically motivated. Work for the company we love. Work for the client, very important. Be a professional. And above all, leave us in peace. Can systems work like these? Yes, they can work. But then you must have a 100% Florex company. This is like a 150-kilo fat guy that buys Nikes. I must be a great athlete because I got the shoes of an athlete. It doesn't work. It can't work in a company that's even slightly Stagnacorp. So, Florex, the good one. What's happening at Florex? The management team of Florex is very heavily engaged in creating relationship amongst each other. This relationship also translates to how they run their departments. But one thing is for sure, the creation of middle managers is one of the purposes of Florex. What is a middle manager? It's like a non-commissioned officer. I define them as highly empowered people that lead a small squad or lead a process. At Florex, there is a doctrine of creating a big layer of sergeants somewhere in the company where it needs to be the most flexible. This is the base of Florex organizations. They create sergeants. The sergeant has an obligation to have a real relationship with his people. And because he is obliged to have this high level of relationship, he is obliged to be their main source of recognition. At Florex, they make the actual decision that the sergeant is deciding if the guy gets the bonus, yes or no. Evaluations, ratings, they're actually made by the sergeant. So the ownership of this guy, of course, is very much dependent that he can make decisions and that he actually owns the people. And that sounds like a really bad thing, but it isn't. You own your children. And once you're going to say, like, no, I don't own them, I'm just the box they came in, or I'm just the one that brought them to this earth. Yeah, when something happens to them, let's see how much you own them. And this requires a great deal of discipline, of course, from all kinds of departments, like HR and marketing, or whatever department wants to interfere in the lives of employees. But at Florex, there was very much the understanding the sergeant is the middleman. And that was a very difficult decision for them, because now, like the sergeant was responsible to get trusted by his people, the company has to trust them, the sergeants. Interdepartmental working together became one of the most important things in the thingy market. No thingy stands alone. This is a, what do you call it, task force project group, Monday morning. Now you can imagine, in order to get recognition from my sergeant, he needs to have an excellent communication with sergeants from other departments, which means that the sergeants of a Florex company, they actually are a band of brothers. I'm a marketing sergeant, and I meet a supply chain sergeant, and we both understand how difficult it is to lead people. A company like Florex has great project teams. Actually, those are the kind of task forces that come from sergeants. This is the flexibility and the true power of any company. You cannot organize. You cannot buy systems. You're way out of this. It only works through relationships. Okay, we have a winner, and it is sales. It kind of figures. So, Florex or Stagnacorp, let's start with Stagnacorp. Like I said, a Stagnacorp sales director is under a very special type of pressure. He has to go to his management team, and the management team says, this has to be the turnover that you make. It has nothing to do with the market. It even has nothing to do with what the competition is doing. This is what we have decided. That has to be sold. In a Stagnacorp, you always get very precise numbers. It's crystal ball, 3578. I call this political precision. And in dealing with his management team, he'd almost be crazy to raise his own results that he has to make. It's going to be translated in budget, and if he can't deliver, he gets killed. And whenever he can't deliver, the other departments are going to interfere with his department. So, what does a Stagnacorp sales director do? He gives in. He gives in to this crowd of demanding people. And you know why he gives in? Remember all the stuff you learned at the beginning. Because he has no relationships there. You see, a sales director, as some of you are, they understand something that I never explained, by the way. There is something called optimum output. Optimum output means there is a certain point that you want turnover, and if you want more turnover, you actually hurt the company. The best way to explain it is in a simple model. We all drive cars, right? You throw gas in the sucker, you start it, and away you go. You see stuff on this instrument panel, like speed, like revolutions of the car, that tell you how fast are you going to fuck up your car. And it tells you, most importantly, your mileage, your fuel consumption. But the only way to know that is by driving it. So, let's say you're sitting in the car and you're driving. What are you looking for when you're driving a car? You're seeking that perfect speed. You're seeking that sweet spot. I actually can go a little bit faster and faster. Until you hit a certain moment. Let's cut this. Whoa. Let's go old school on this. Wait a second. So, this is what we call, professionals call, a graph. And this is speed. In this example, speed could be the same thing as turnover. And this is mileage. How much mileage can you get out of 10 liters of gas? And you can say the mileage is something called profit. So, here is a car. And somehow, when you start driving, there's a certain speed where the mileage suddenly drops. There is a certain speed that if you go over it, the car gets too hot or the car is not built for it. What's the essence of the story? If the driver is the driver, if a sales director can be a sales director, he can determine that speed, but because you only can determine that by driving this car. You're the one who knows your organization. You know from what point of turnover pressure are your people going to fuck up deals. At what moment are you going to give discounts at such a proportion that you can never come with another offer to this client without offering the same discounts? From a certain moment on, if you go for more turnover, you fuck up the organization, like you destroy a car. So, profit at a certain moment that there's a sweet point. And like I said, I call this optimum output. At a certain moment, you have to choose around this point. I'm going a little bit faster, a little bit slower. So what is the management team? The management team is other directors that want their budgets filled in. They become like a screaming family in the backseat saying, faster, daddy, faster, faster, faster. And a wife next to you is doing the same. Actually, he has to go a lot faster. And this is the point where you lose out greatly. Questions about optimum output. Lady, think fast.
How long are you able to stay at the optimum output point?
Good question. The optimum output point is flexible. If you go uphill, the whole graph goes like this. If you go downhill and you have the wind in your back, it will move like this. Here comes the beauty of it. What if the people that judge you, the management team, they don't want to listen about situations like we go uphill or we go downhill. They just want the predetermined optimum output point, or as much as possible. They go like, oh, you gave a forecast. But I understand the market is changing all the time. Good, so what we need to do is we have to screw down our expectations. No, we're not going to do that. Otherwise, I'm going to take over your whole department and we're going to push the results my way. So, there is a gap between the sales director and his colleagues. And there's also a bigger gap between the sales director and his team, the people that actually have to do the selling. He involves himself in sale activities. The reality is, and this is, in my opinion, in 90% of the cases, he just cherry-picks the big accounts for himself. He's not supporting a sales team. He's not empowering people. He's not creating sales sergeants. He's not taking a risk that somebody might fuck up a sale. He just cherry-picks the big accounts. Why does he do this? Well, for starters, there is no trust within Stagna Corp, so he doesn't trust the people around him. And also, when he has to deal with the management board, remember, then he can always say, I know what I'm talking about. So when he gets bothered by his fellow directors, he can say, well, I have this meeting with our big client tomorrow. It also gives us a very strong impression that he leads from the front and that he's goal-oriented. And in the back of the mind of all Stagna Corp directors, there's also knowing the largest accounts doesn't hurt my sense of job security either, because nobody feels safe in a Stagna Corp company. You can imagine soon his sergeants follow his example with the smaller fishes. So this becomes the sales culture of a Stagna Corp corporation. And they follow that example very much for the same reasons. At Florex, it's the other way around, because the Florex sales director doesn't have to sell himself as the all-conquering, all-selling alpha male to his own team. So in other words, they rely on him to build a great sales team. They don't rely on him to be a great seller. Think how primitive Stagna Corp actually thinks if you compare it to Florex. So, remember, we went from the CEO to the directors, from the directors to one department we would choose. You people chose sales. Now we talk about the sales sergeant. This is a sales sergeant. Why the hell does he look like this? He must be a Stagna Corp sales sergeant. As I said before, the middle managers have very little power at Stagna Corp, and the sales middle manager, of course, are no exception. So let's go into a few things. His director chooses him usually because he makes great presentations. So if you take this sales sergeant to a meeting, he's going to make a great PowerPoint and he's going to show that he's really proficient in making graphs. So when we need political precision, you need sergeants like this. You recognize what I'm saying? Raise your hand if you have known sergeants like this. Wow. Yeah. Now you know where they come from. He also knows, and this is so important, his own sales director doesn't fight for him. So what happens? When sales go down even a little bit, the vultures come in. And who are the vultures? Well, HR, for example. They come up with a program that the sergeant is forced to sit with his own people every 3 months, and he will ask them about their values. It's a value program. Are you still complying with our values? And we've chosen transparency, and we've chosen entrepreneurship, and we have chosen sexual prowess. I don't know, they've chosen things. And then they have to sit together with the people. What the hell do we have to fill in? I don't know, but we need to send this form to HR. Doesn't count for my bonus. I don't know. They say it does, and it doesn't. I don't know. How many programs like this did we have already? Yeah, 1,000. And a lot of times, people really play these systems. A lot of salespeople, they notice already that scoring with these kind of systems sometimes pays even more than making real results. And you understand, of course, these become the future sergeants of Stagna Corp. And then there's, of course, programs like customer orientation. That means client is king. We're going to hang posters everywhere where the client is central, because now all the arrows point to the client. The client, I don't know, the client. And it sounds so beautiful, because that's what Stagna Corp is about. It sounds more beautiful than Florex. All the questions you ask me, we try to find Florex more beautiful than Stagna Corp, but actually from the outside, Stagna Corp looks more beautiful, like an Italian sports car. You really have to open it to find out that it's filters crap, it's pasta. So, client is king. What's wrong with that? It's a typical Stagna Corp theory. It is based on no relationships. How is that? Because the client is not the most important person. The most important person is your own colleagues, your own people. So let's say I work at Stagna Corp. I worked there already for 15 or 20 years. I work my ass off. One letter, one angry letter from a client can ruin me. And as soon as this angry letter comes in, I have to go to my sergeant and some manager I hardly ever saw, and they're going to say, we would like to hear two sides of the story. I don't want that. I want my company to choose for me. But a Stagna Corp company never chooses for its own people. So no matter how long you work there, no matter what results you created, in a Stuckner corporation, you're never safe, never pays to take a risk. And then there's marketing. He comes to the sergeants and they say, this is what's going wrong during sales encounters. They don't use the right materials. Here's the materials. This is the funny hat they have to wear. This is the scuba dive equipment that they need when they speak with clients. And they always have to talk through a sponge. Because a focus group has determined that this is the best way to sell thingies. You understand madness? And of course, at one way or the other, marketing already has hijacked the clients they're going to visit. So the Stuckner sergeants are just there to measure. You got to understand, Stuckner Corp is also the company that really heavily invested in all kinds of, what you call it? Yeah, that stuff. SAP, bought market research. Everything that has to do with this is where your people have to go. Sergeants are there to fulfill the promise that all this bought market research will have. So we're now going to choose the best clients. And of course, companies, SAP, etc., they come up with, these are the fattest thingy buyers in the market. And of course, they sell exactly the same data to others. So what you get is very fat clients that get visited by everyone. In the pharmaceutical industry, this is happening already for 60 years. Actually, because they have to go to the places where the company says you have to go, in the end, visiting the right amount and visiting the right clients becomes more important than even the success. Because that's a bigger KPI. In Florex, meanwhile, the picture looks entirely different. Sales director at Florex wants to select the best of the best. He has to find somebody who will be a source of recognition for his own salespeople. And that's not an easy one. He is the one that gets the sole possession of his sales team. He becomes a tactical officer based on real relationships in the market, based on his relationship with his own people, and based on all these things, he makes a plan. And he becomes a true corporation inside the area that he has, a corporation completely focused in conquering the thingy market in the place that they have to work in. And these tactical sergeants make mincemeat of competition. You see, sometimes we think Stuckner Corps are the bad guys and Florex are the good guys. No, Florex can be very bad guys. I like it when we are the bad guys. At Florex, they can try things because everything is led by a sergeant. This is the product we have? Yes, try find new USPs. You can also say try find new markets. And they can do it because the sales director backs them up all the time and the sergeant backs them up all the time. So this is the place where somebody can actually say, listen, I have a great idea. I need 2 days to find it out. I'm going to try something. And the sergeant says, go ahead. In a Stuckner Corps corporation, it's even impossible. Of course, they like to read books about shit like that, but it never happens. We had the sergeant, now we speak about the sales team. Something happens to people when they are left by their generals. You all remember the golden calf. Of course they create an own god. They go like, what do we work for? And they make a calf. In case of salespeople, it's always turnover. Turnover means they can never hurt me as long as I have turnover. And because the monster that's above you is feeding you also, we need turnover. That's what you believe. It's all about turnover. When you do business with a Stuckner Corp corporation, count on it. That one of the goals of the sales is always, can we make proposals? Not even the orders, proposals. Because creating as many proposals as possible becomes a goal on itself. It's better to shotgun proposals into the market and even to lose than not to make the proposal and skip somebody on your SAP generated list that the computer spewed out that you had to visit. By the way, the proposals are not made by me. Somebody else has to make the proposal. It's another department. Of course, you can imagine that the level of relationship that Stuckner Corp salespeople make is terrible. They make a lot of proposals. They don't make relationships. Can you imagine that the veteran salespeople from Stuckner Corp, they start to think of their job as a game? Yeah, I know the game by now. Because all the customers look the same to him. Why? No relationship. If you don't have to have that, people do look the same. So you have to understand, they don't make deals made on relationship, they make deals based on price. Price becomes king. Lowering prices, kickback destructions, everything possible. Their clients even start to calculate how much they may earn. Then the client says, okay, now I'm going to be a typical buyer. You didn't make relationship with me. You shotgunned proposals at me. So now I'm going to treat you like the shit you are. And I'm going to calculate how much you may earn. I'm going to squeeze you. And this feeds the idea of Stagnacorp salespeople that this is how the world works. It means that the sales go all right, but the profit fails. They go way over their maximum output. So what happens next at Stagnacorp? The board of directors is not entirely stupid. They see what sales is doing. They're going to say, okay, you cannot make any kickback constructions anymore. You cannot lower the prices. No more discounts. No more tricks. So what happens next? And this is an interesting one. The Stagnacorp sales are going to find all kinds of creative ways to give freebies to the client. Thingy spectral analyzers. Thingy technical support. Everything that they can take off the floor or pull out of the wall of their own company, they throw in the deal. Because it is not part of their bonus. It's part of somebody else's bonus. This is how Stagnacorp people work. Think. Remember how the board works. How the whole story finds itself down to exactly the same behavior and exactly the same way of thinking. So they give away everything for free. As much as possible. If I would be training the company, they would actually ask me, listen, do you also give training for clients of clients? Sometimes, I don't know, what are you supposing? Well, maybe I can throw you in, because you get paid by another department anyway. Clever, clever. Do you recognize it from salespeople? Raise your hands. Wow. Try to find a book where they actually talk about it. These are the things they never speak about. Okay. What happens next? Well, the departments that get everything given away from, they go badly indeed, because they have to spend a lot of money fulfilling all the freebies that sales gives away. Let's say I sell thingies, but there's also another product called cubes. And I'm a client who wants to buy thingies, but unfortunately also have some broken cubes. And I want to sell. So what do? As a Stagnacorp salesman, tell you what, we're also going to repair your cubes. And I go to the technical department, and I'm going to say, they have cubes too, repair them. And I say, this is not what I'm hired for. I'm hired to sell, to repair our own products. Yeah, but the client wants it. So this is the argument that they hear all the time. The client wants it. There's no argument against it. These support departments, they have costs that are like tremendous, because they are being hunted by salespeople that try to get value out of them everywhere where they can. They steal the toilet paper to give to their clients because it will not damage their own turnover. So what happens is the relationship between the Stagnacorp salespeople and the support people, it declines. And interdepartmental task forces, of course, it declines too. We all went through that. I want to go one step further into this process. We went from the CEO, I want to end up as the client. The problem is actually the sales process that's destroyed. When you visit a couple that's on the verge of divorce, you ever had that situation? Not that you got divorced, but you visit people that are about to divorce. And do you notice at a moment like that, that they cannot... You guys are genius. Good example. Do you notice, by the way, whoa, keep this one. She is always looking at the camera. She's never looking at the guy she's with. She's with a lot of guys, but she's always looking at the camera. It's true. Anyway, you visit people that are at the verge of divorce. How long can they hide for you that they actually don't have a relationship anymore? Very shortly, until you notice something is wrong here. You guys don't need to be expert, but you see this in minutes. I mean, she is looking at you, he's looking at you, they're talking, but they're not talking to each other. It's not three people sitting in a room, it's two people sitting in a room talking to you. You notice this. And you can imagine that these people of Stagna Corps, they avoid taking somebody with them at all costs. And once they take somebody with them, they don't say to the client, my good friend is coming. They're going to say, I take somebody from that department with me. And when that guy from that department starts to talk with the client and says, oh, I have a little presentation here about a thingy output when we put our special, then the salesperson is sitting here looking in his bag. What am I going to tell the guy? Understand, people, the more complicated and interdepartmental your product is, this will break your back, no matter what business you're in. At Florex, of course, yeah, the reality of the sales team is completely different. They're profit-driven instead of turnover-driven. Remember that empowered sergeant? He is somebody that can actually calculate whether a deal is profitable or not. His people get recognition for deals that really make money. They make relationship with clients. So the sales proposals they make, they use their USPs, very, very customized to what the client really wants. It's a hard one to explain. You are?
Boss.
You're married to?
Floor.
Is she your boss?
No.
She's... Is she a manager?
No.
She's your floor manager. Oh, this is a bad one even for me. Is she beautiful?
Yeah.
Good. I get a budget for 500 euros to buy a beautiful gift for beautiful Mrs. Floor. You get 50 euros. Who will buy the most beautiful present?
I do.
I get 10 more times more budget than you do. So how come you get a better present? You have a relationship with her, of course. So you can imagine if you have a relationship, you always win. With all the personal information that comes in. The proposals of Stagna Corp compared to those of Florex, the ones of Florex are far fewer and far more successful. At Stagna Corp, proposals are a tool, a means to get a sale. Hope I get a good price this time. At Florex, they are just a part of a much wider universe. How many times did you hear that you have a contract being broken, a marriage contract, that the marriage contract gets canceled because we couldn't agree on the price or we couldn't agree on the agreements? The marriage contract is a ceremony that you do the moment everything else is decided already, like we want a relationship with each other. At Stagna Corps, the decision still has to be made when the proposal is out. Can you imagine a marriage contract being sent out? I hope they're going to do it. It's the same way of thinking, people. You already made the decision. Unless there's completely no relationship, and then, you guys get it. And because, of course, there's a relationship within Florex, better customizing. It's exactly bus and floor. For 50 euros, you can do miracles. And I'm just an outsider, I just know her name, so I have to spend 500, and she's still going to choose for you. And if I say, I have 5,000, he has 5, he finds something very symbolic, and she's going to say, oh, boss. And I come home with a gift of 5,000, she says, I already have one. You buy everything for Florina, don't you? Of course you do. When you go to client, in a Florex way, you come with somebody that you have a relationship with, and you've got to understand, the more complicated the product is that you sell, the client sees that if in the future something goes wrong, the person that's there will do it for the guy that's also there. Here are two people that work for each other, and the client decides for Florex. Okay, question. Could a Florex manager turn a Stagna Corp company... Oh, wow. That's a great question. May I dare ask who asked it? Okay, thank you. It's a good question. Tell you what. Let's throw it to the people. Could a Florex manager turn a Stagna Corp company into a Florex company? Who thinks yes? Who thinks no? No has the majority. Who said no? Why can't a Florex manager not turn Stagna Corp into a Florex company? What will happen?
I think he's a hazard. He's
maybe a little bit rebellious against the systems that are in place.
That's true. It's all true, but it's not completely the reason. Throw it to the guy in front of you.
I think it will go wrong because this Florex manager is capable of building relations, but the other ones will not accept it. And to have a relation, it must go two ways.
So what happens if some Florex guy comes in and people want his recognition? He's going to get killed. Stagna Corps always wins from Florex. Do understand that. Somebody who wants to keep a room clean will always lose from somebody who wants to make it dirty. There's a high price to pay for Florex. People here know that. Absolutely correct.
What if the Florex manager is a really top manager, so very high in the board of directors? Is it then still possible to make it a Florex company?
It helps, but it's no solution. Lots of examples like that. Like Ned Stark in Game of Thrones. He gets beheaded anyway. What does it take, actually? It sometimes takes that you make relationship with another Florex manager and another one. Sometimes it takes that you make your department Stagna Corp free. Sometimes it takes that you actually decide, I am a Florex person, and at least I'm going to take care of the few people that are under my charge. But it happens a lot, and that is the most painful things that I see, that a real Florex guy tries to take over a Stagna Corp corporation, and they kill him. And those are the biggest tragedies that I see. I have seen it in my life 12 times, really. And really, like almost like a situation like in Game of Thrones. So no, there is no savior.
No hope. Okay. Okay, thank you.
Unfortunately not.
Arnold?
Yep?
Are you now saying that there is no way that one can create a Florex company? Because that's the impression I'm getting now.
Of course you can create them. But the problem is, the question here was, can one man do it? And the answer is absolutely not. It's sheep against wolves. And it's not like there is one Rambo super sheep with two guns on his back and a bandana saying, we kill wolves. And sometimes in trainings and after trainings, I have to warn for that. I really have to warn for that, because people also start to feel guilty. They recognize a lot in their own company, and then they have the idea, I have to do it this also, and if they don't, then I'm a coward. No, you're not. Tonight I wanted to connect the dots. And this is what I do. I connect dots in people's minds so they can make a decision. I want to be Stagna Corp, I want to be Florex, I want to be in between. But I hope tonight we created a little bit more Florex in this life. And again, I so much want to thank you for being here tonight and for your attentive listening. Thank you.